pertaining to cyst, wherein it is observed in the case of your Vaucheria and Botrytium. संकेत सर ऊपर का मेरा छोटा स्क्रीन आता है खाली आई डोंट नो व्हाई हाँ हो गया बड़ा आ गया एनीवे नाउ सिस्ट इज बेसिकली आई होप यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ सिनोसाइटिक आई फॉरगॉट वी हैड हर्ड अबाउट दिस वर्ड सिनोसाइटिक कैन एनीवन टेल मी द मीनिंग ऑफ सिनोसाइटिक Cysts are produced in sinusitic forms. I don't know the meaning of this, my dear. Who is going to help me out? Sinusitic forms. If you can recollect, we had done fungi last year. It is filamentous structure. It is showing the septas. In between, there is a nucleus. It is a filamentous structure. But the septas are absent, nucleus is present. Bolo. What do you mean by the term sinusitic? Nobody? All sleeping? Aila, main bhul gayi, yani ki aap log bhi bhul gaye. Aisa nahi chalta hai. The first one, if you see this diagram, which I've drawn it with pencils lightly, just to explain you all. That is nothing but nucleated, correct? एक एक सेल में एक एक न्यूक्लियस है ना? फिलामेंट को सेप्टास डालके उसको डिवाइड किया है तो एक एक सेल में एक एक न्यूक्लियस है तो इट इज यूनि न्यूक्लियेटेड याद है बराबर है ओके और दूसरे वाले में सेप्टास नहीं है लेकिन न्यूक्लियस है तो मेनी न्यूक्लिया है करेक्ट हो ना Then there are many nuclei, we call the term as sinusitic. Which you commonly call it, I am writing it over here. Multi-nucleated. Yaad rahega abhi? Multi-nucleated is nothing but sinusitic forms. So cyst is generally observed in sinusitic forms. That means multi-nucleated. They are thick-walled. They are thick-walled, and they are said to be the resting spores. They are said to be resting spores. That means when the conditions are not favorable, each spore will later on form. Each spore will later on form a new plant. Spores will later on germinate to form new plants. Correct? Yeah, the next one that is called as autospores. Autospores are observed in the members of algae. Members of chlorococcales. Correct? What is there in this? These are also resting spores. These are also said to be resting spores. They are born. Similar to our parents. Your next one, both of them are fungi. Correct? If you try to recollect, this is the mycelium, the vertical columella, and on the top it shows the sporangium. Yes, sporangium ke andar jo spores rehta hai, that is called as the sporangiospores. Yaad aa raha hai? Dhundla sa last year kiya tha. आइडेंटिफिकेशन प्रैक्टिकल्स में किया होगा ये आपने सड़ा हुआ ब्रेड का टुकड़ा मिस ने रखा होगा उसका स्लाइड बनाया होगा कापूस के जैसा जो था करेक्ट ना ऐसा दिखता था वो दैट इज नथिंग बट द स्पोरेंजियोस्पोर्स दीज आर नॉन मोटाइल दीज आर नॉन मोटाइल They are produced in lower fungi. Produced in lower fungi. That is nothing but your mucor and rhizopus. They are belonging to phycomycetes. That's why they are the lower fungi. Then the spores are exogenous in origin. I hope you all know the meaning of exogenous. The spores are, it is endogenous. The spores are endogenous in origin. I hope you all know the meaning now. Correct? This is observed in the case of Penicillium. It is also observed in the case of Aspergillus. It is also observed in the case of Fusarium. All these are nothing but fungi. You can recollect in your textbook, there is a small diagram. Somewhat this way, one cell is there, then the branching there. Then again, this is for the bifurcating into branchings. And then you can see the conidias. Now these conidiospores are formed externally. So they are said to be exogenous in origin. Pehla wala endogenous tha, andar se tha. Ye bahar se hai. So they are called as exogenous in origin. The spores are non-motile. Spores are non-motile. Then they are produced in higher fungi. Pehla wala lower fungi tha. These are produced in higher fungi. Moreover, these can overcome the unfavorable conditions. They can overcome the unfavorable conditions. The spores are exogenous in origin. Agreed. The spores are exogenous in origin. They are conidiospores. You have the next one. Last two are there. That is Soridia. This is observed in the case of lichens, which is having talus form. What is they are? They are the minute bud-like structures. They are the minute bud-like structures, which in turn are developed on the surface as well as margins. And during favorable conditions, they will give rise to new plants. The last one is Isidia. Now I will just make a note of it, what all things are there and what all things are not there for you all. Example, Fruticos. Yes, lichen. Fruticos or Folios lichen will show the presence of Isidia. Correct? These are coral-like. I hope you all know how the coral structure is. Always bifurcating. Correct? So these are coral-like. That is the Isidia. Outgrowth. These are coral-like outgrowths on the thallus. Correct? In this inner layer is algae, and outer layer is fungi. Correct? The same way, if you go to see even Soridia, center is algae surrounded by fungi. Agreed? Now, what all things you all are supposed to remember is zoospores, conidiospores. आपको सिलेबस में दो है लेकिन ये सारा आपके पास रहने दो, आप पढ़ाई मत करो इसका, ये नीट वगैरह में जब जाओगे तभी सब चाहिएगा आपको, क्योंकि अभी कर रहे थे तो ध्यान में आना चाहिए, इसके लिए कर दिया. Agreed? Now, apart from this, another phenomena you have is budding. Normally आपने हाइड्रा में देखा था लास्ट ईयर, करेक्ट? वो आप इवन एनिमल रिप्रोडक्शन में भी देखोगे. मिस विल डू देयर आल्सो. ये हाइड्रा इज अटैच्ड टू द सबस्ट्रेटम. नेक्स्ट यू विल सी द टेंटेकल्स, द गोनैड्स. समवेयर यू विल सी अ स्मॉल हाइड्रा बीइंग प्रोट्रूडिंग ओवर हियर, करेक्ट? दिस इज नथिंग बट द बड. द मोमेंट इट गेट्स मैच्योर्ड it will be detached from the parent and will survive on its own. So this phenomena is budding. It is a bud. The phenomena is budding. And this example is nothing but hydra. ये हम लोग को animal में जाएगा, इसके लिए इधर नहीं करना है. But some books are showing it in the market also, the books which are available now, they are showing it. So I am doing it for you. You have to remember about this. This is nothing but a single unicellular structure. It is showing a large vacuole and a single nucleus. This structure is nothing but yeast, a fungus. What is happening? This particular structure will show a pinching of the cell wall at the one end. That pinching of the cell wall at one end, which is there, in turn, will go on becoming more deeper and deeper. This is vacuole, the same way nucleus. Ultimately, this nucleus is also now going to divide. A part of it will go there. Vacuole. Nucleus over and nucleus over here. Now, since the nucleus is gone, this will get detached. So you will have a phenomena of budding. Correct? This is observed in the case of yeast. This phenomena is called as budding. Agreed? So right from spores onwards, concentrate on zoospores observed in Eulatrix. They are motile due to the presence of flagella or cilia. They are naked. They are produced within the zoosporangium. Then you have coleospores observed in the case of your higher fungi, that is Penicillium, Aspergillus, etc. The spores are non-motile. These spores are formed under the unfavorable conditions. The spores are exogenous in origin. These spores in turn are called as conidiospores because they are arising from conidia. Here's the next phenomena, which is called as budding. In the case of budding, it is observed in unicellular structure of fungus, that is yeast. A single cell is there in the presence of vacuole and the nucleus. This is further continued. The invagination of the cell membrane or the cell wall is taking place. This will go on becoming deeper till part of the nucleus is also entering into that structure. So you get the phenomena of bud formation. This bud will get detached from the parent cell and will form a new fungi or a new yeast cell. Along with this, you do come across the structure called as bulbil. You do come across the structure which is called as bulbil. If you can recollect, actually that you can do it for vegetative propagation also. But here in the case of your agave, you have the plant or the, this is giving rise to a bud, a new plant. So you call it as bulbil. In agave americana, you get the bulbil formation, and that in turn is giving rise to a new plant because it is attached to the parent plant and then it gets separated. Once it is capable of surviving on its own, then you call it as a bulbil. This is all something pertaining to the spore. So we have done asexual mode of reproduction either by means of binary fission or by means of fragmentation or by means of spore formation or by means of bulbil. Now, by means of vegetative propagation, you have two different modes. I told you all over there itself. I have written is NNA, natural and artificial. So that same thing I'll write. It is composed of two different forms. That is either natural vegetative propagation or artificial vegetative propagation. Yes. Natural vegetative propagation is done by the creator itself. You and I cannot do it. It is done by creator. In which the vegetative part is there, that is root. Correct? This root, adventitious roots, are forming tuberous roots. Correct? Adventitious roots are forming tuberous roots. These tuberous roots are doing the function of storage, are doing the function of vegetative propagation, as well as they are helpful for perination. That is to overcome the unfavorable condition. Ye sara last year humne morphology of flowering plants mein kiya tha, yaad aa raha hai? You'll have done it. This will be a down the structure. This way, the leaf is there. From the axil of the leaf, some roots are coming out. They will take a turn and enter into the soil. These are nothing but tuberous roots. Observed in the case of your sweet potato. Yaad aa raha hai? Sakkarkand. Sakkariya, sakkarkand, sweet potato, Ipomoea batata. Ye sab terms bole the hum log ne last year.
Ji.
Along with this, you have studied also this part. That is in the case of Shatavari asparagus. This is the main stem. The roots are bifurcated. The roots are bifurcated palm-like. You had called them also as tuberous roots. They are also helpful for... Hello? Okay. Okay, thank you. When is the next lecture, sir? Hello. Okay, you let me know then. Yeah. Your voice is gone. Okay, thank you.